Hey all together and welcome to the Starcraft 2 Crazy Replays! Today, again on UK Pressing Tournament Edition, White Edition! But this time with a TVC in the bottom right hand side. The Bluestirk Brainalop or Branalop. Branlop maybe. Playing against me in the bottom left hand side, the red Terran, Lexasha. Ooh. That's some weird scouting. Look at that. Boing, 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 boing. Then over there, and back there, and there, there. That's not very efficient. He's scouting many locations twice. That's weird, but okay, he's going for pool first. Okay, that's not too bad. Pool first can work sometimes. And sure, why not? Why not? So pool first. Then the hatchery, and I assume the gas next? But probably not. We will see. There we go, gas finally. Still no scouting. I mean, he didn't scout here. Or here. Or here. Ah, here is okay. Or here. Oh, wow. I mean, you could attack right here. Or here. So his scouting wasn't the best, I would say. He covered something, but not everything, so that's a little bit weird. I like the sling run by. Definitely times out perfectly with the Reaper to be most annoying. So that's nice for Branlop. But will it be enough to completely screw me over? I'm still playing the 2-1-1, as you can see right here. Bam. But here come the Zerglings. So I see the queen and know exactly. Uh-oh. And yeah, there we go. Already delayed, which is not good. There we go. This Zergling is fighting and gets one kill. Already paid for itself. This is good. Already paid for itself. Shouldn't get another one. But can be most annoying. Oh, does he get another one? No! Ooh, that hurts. That really hurts. That was so unnecessary. So, two Zerglings for two SCVs. The problem is this kind of situation is so difficult to practice if you don't have a practice partner, as it happens not all the time. In fact, I would say it happens maybe every fifth game or so, at least to me. So, nothing you can really practice. And then, of course, it differs if it's with speed. Are there six Zerglings, only two, maybe four? Or, as I said, speedlings, it depends. But he's going for some really early lair tech, look at that. And additional gases, so this might, with four gases, I would say it should be Nautilus play. Roach play normally, if you come, there we go, Spire Bam. If you go for, like it was in... Oh, come on, in Heart of the Swarm. Then it was like 3 extractor is Roach play, with Nidus potentially, and 4 is for the Spire. But he's going for a Baneling Nest as well. This, I think the Baneling Nest costs gas. I can't look it up, but I think that's the case. Oh, he loses one Overlord. That's a big blow to his build order, I would say. The Reaper, not really able to scout. The Reaper shouldn't be able to scout. Oh wow! So now I definitely can confirm the lair. And there should be the scan. Scan? No scan? I'm playing blind? Am I really playing blind? Oh right, when both buildings finish up. So I see the Baneling Nest and the Spire. And I see that he lets it finish. Wow, premium. That looks so weird. Okay, so 4 mutalists on the way as well as speed. His economy not that far behind actually, I wonder why. So a bunker at the front, just in case. I'm not moving out, I know he's coming. Roach Warren behind us and Evil Chamber, so he's going for all the tech. But it's a little bit weird, I have to say. So there are the mutalisks. Finally a third hatchery. One missile turret gets dropped down here. And will finish in time, I guess. So that's nice. Where's the Ebay? There's the Ebay. There's one turret. There's one turret, so I'm completely safe. Whoopsie. And I don't think he will find too much damage here. Not at all. And that's bad for him. That was a huge investment. And now he's quite far behind. He got some tag, yes, but overall, I'm not sure. You got 8 mutalists now in total, 7, 10, 9, 9, okay. And this turret is holding strong. There's a bunker which you cannot really attack. Yeah, some damage on the supply depot, which is okay, but I don't know. At least he got one overseer to spot any widow mines. And now he goes for the missile turret, but the turret gets one kill. For one mutalisk, already paid for itself this turret. And looks like I'm dropping on top of here. And he needs to retreat. I think I didn't lose. Oh, he lost the overseer. And I lost nothing in the whole process. Now he's again supply blocked. He's marching across with some roaches. No, maybe not. Still active with the mutalisk. And he needs those mutalisks to pinch me back as long as possible into my main base, or my side of the map, which he currently is doing a really good job of. But oh no, oh no, oh no! RIP! And that's the end of his containment. So now I can move across the map. Oh, will I get one mutalisk? Yes, so he has one mutalisk left. He goes for 3 more. That's some interesting, very interesting decision making here. But some banelings, he has enough roaches. Army wise I am ahead, but maybe he can hold on, depending on how I play this out. If I have good controls, this will be the end. But it looks like widow mines are not burrowed. Oh, some nice connectors, but not on the banes. Ah, huge mistake with the medevac here. And now he has enough roaches, good upgrades. All those roaches are bruised but not killed. And this trade went horribly wrong for me. Yeah, nice with the Ravager cocoon. Healing up those units perfectly, that's good. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Ooh. He's taking some damage from the widow mines. So the widow mines itself paid for them itself as well. That was okay, but overall, not looking good for me. My micro not on point. Upgrades not on point either. At least I have somewhat of a transition, but to be fair, I should have all those buildings I'm building right now ready and the fourth base on the way. That wasn't too no, this was really expensive, to be honest. Oh, idle SCVs, come on, come on, stop being idle. Oh my goodness, that's not good. So one drop to the main base, one drop to the potential fourth base. Okay, I see, this could happen and work. We will see. More banelings being morphed. So Roach, Ravager, Bane. A weird combination, but it can work, as you can see. Does he see it? Yes, he should be prepared. He should react, which he currently isn't doing. There we go. Nice reaction time. Loses only 2 or 3 drones. Some circlings. Not too much, actually. But this is huge. No cancel. Bam! That was awesome. And I killed one baneling as well. And here we drop again. Maybe we don't. Yes, we do. Behind that, macro, 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 as good as I can, of course. Which is not really good, but it's okay enough. And here we go again, scan, kill some creep. Maybe one roach. Or we lose everything. Still dropping here. I might just get one overseer here. Any damage is good damage. So this drop is over. I should have reinforced those drop locations, like send two more medivacs over here, clear the creep, drop into the natural, drop here again, because now I could drop again. There's no overlord to spot. You need one overlord here, so important. But there is none. I could drop further, but I decide to go back. I don't have any tanks. It's bad. Oh, I see his army. The upgrades are favoring me, but the units itself favoring him. Ooh. Not too bad. So the Widowmines burrowed, but Widowmines are not that great against Roach Ravager. You need tanks against this composition. Looks like I can kill some units. That's nice. Ah, kill this Ravager. There we go. And this is not much damage, but it's something, you know? Oh, dodging the bites like a professional here, but I need to macro up more heavily. Now he's maxed out, so this means he can. Oh, the biles! Ooh, losing one medivac there. Nice Widowmine connection. So now he can go. He could go for more tech. Oh, that hurts! But a huge drop in the main base. So. Or maybe not. Now this is some weird attack. I'm not sure if he can defend this properly. It looks like currently he can. The main base is not looking too good for him, but maybe he can defend. He's still on bad upgrades. He's one set of upgrades behind. 8 marines left, should retreat. Huge attack at the third base, not dodging all the biles. And I need to escape, but I don't lose too many. Oh, nice, Widowmine. But I don't lose too many medivacs, that's good. That is really good. And he's still. Yeah, now he's all in. The main is dry, the natural is dry. He's all in. I'm quite all in as well, but now I got a fourth command center, I am fine. Oh no, the Widowmines. Wow. Oh, don't run into your own corrosive piles. The problem is, this is his last ditch effort. If it fails, then that's basically game, because he doesn't really have the opportunity to go for a third base. I pulled the SCVs, the damage is huge, I don't have much army left, and I'm losing all those SCVs. Look at that! Ooh, that's not good. Oh, those piles were beautiful. It looks like I'm heavily overextending here. But I need to retreat back. Can I hold on? The upgrades are really a big part of this game. He doesn't have much left, that's the sad part. His income is still looking okay-ish, but not really good. Now with the Liberator, that's looking even worse. Maybe we should have just gone for some Banshees, but... Oh, that's a nice corrosive pile, but not enough to kill those two Liberator. And I can dance around those Liberation Zones. And slowly but surely push forward. And he tries his best. He needs another base, but he can't do it because he needs to build army in order to apply the pressure, to keep the pressure up. But it's not working. Slowly but surely, I guess I'm winning here in this game. As you can see, gas-wise, mineral-wise, I'm just trading better. I don't know how the economy was looking. I don't have one economy graph on this overlay. I would love to have one, but I don't know if there is one. I will look this up. But this should be game. I mean, what else is there for him to do? Nothing. Nothing left but to type GG. Yeah, that's not working as intended. He's just too far behind in terms of economy and upgrades now. There we go, GG. So thank you so much for watching this episode of the Starcraft 2 Crazy Replays. I hope you enjoyed. As always, I wish you a very nice day and goodbye. Heyo there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions? Put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye-bye.